Hello everyone. In our previous sessions, we have studied many different shapes, where we first started with shape having edges, followed by some curved objects with curved edges. Now, before we start with this session, here is a question for you which will introduce a new shape. Suppose we have an object which, when placed on the ground, only a single point of it touches the ground. Further, this object can be easily rolled. So, can you guess the object? Let me give you another hint. This type of object is also used in playing many games. Yes, you guessed it right. It is a ball. And we come across many such round-shaped objects in our daily life, like some fruits and vegetables, as well as the planets of our solar system, which are all round in shape. In other words, all these round-shaped objects are also called as spherical objects. Many people think that a sphere and a circle are one and the same, which is not correct. If you are given an exercise to draw a sphere on a paper, is it possible to draw it? It may look like a sphere because some artists draw it in such a way as to seem like a three-dimensional image. But in fact, anything drawn on paper cannot be three-dimensional. So it will be a circle only. Whereas a sphere is a three-dimensional object. Apart from these differences, they do share some similarities. Like in a circle, the distance of each and every point on the boundary from its center is always constant. That distance we know as the radius. Similar would be the case with a sphere. Only here, instead of a boundary, we call it as the curved surface. A sphere is quite different from other three-dimensional objects. So let's see what makes it different. Friends, a sphere has no edges or vertices, therefore the entire surface is included as only one surface. Whereas other three-dimensional objects have edges, which further divide their entire surface into number of different surfaces. So like the other objects, which we have already learned in our previous sessions, how can we calculate surface area of a sphere? Since it is round in shape with no edges, therefore it is a bit difficult to find its surface area. But we can make it easier to understand if we relate it with the curved or round shaped objects. Let's do it. We all have seen cylinder, which is a curved object. And you know, when radius of a sphere and a cylinder are same, then that sphere could easily be fitted in the cylinder. And let the height of the cylinder equal to the height of the sphere, which is in fact the diameter of the sphere. Then it is proved by the great mathematician Archimedes that the lateral surface area of the cylinder will be same as the surface area of the sphere. And we know that the lateral surface area of a cylinder is 2 pi rh, where r is the radius and h represents the height of the cylinder, which can also be replaced by the diameter of the sphere. And hence, it can be written as 2 into radius. Thus, the surface area of a sphere is derived as 4 times pi r squared. Friends, we can also relate it with the circle and say that the surface area of a sphere is 4 times area of a circle, right? Okay, so let's see what have we learned till now. We learned that a sphere is a three-dimensional object and the lateral surface area of a cylinder is equal to the surface area of a sphere, which is calculated by the formula 4 pi r squared, which we also say that 4 times area of a circle. So let's move a step ahead and try out an exercise. If we have to make a football with a diameter of 22 cm, then how much of a leather sheet will it need? Friends, we all have seen football. And the question is asking about the leather sheet, which is actually representing the surface of the sphere. So for finding out the requirement of leather sheet, we will find out the surface area of this football. And for that, we need only one parameter, that is the radius. And here we have to make the football of diameter 22 cm. That means radius is 11 cm. So let's put the value of radius into the formula and we will get 1519.76 cm². That means it will need 1519.76 cm² of leather sheet. So guys, this is how we make use of formula in different scenario. It is also used in many ways which we are going to learn in our upcoming sessions. For now, we proceed further and see what else we can get from a sphere. For instance, if we cut a sphere into two equal parts, these two half-cut spheres are called hemispheres. So guys, if surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r squared, then what would be the surface area of a hemisphere? Well, we think that it would be half of the surface area of a sphere, that is 2 pi r squared, which is correct, but only in the case of a hollow hemisphere. For example, if we cut a tennis ball in half, which is hollow inside, here we will get circular edge but not the circular surface. Whereas a solid hemisphere has a circular edge, which divides the surface into two surfaces. One would be the curved surface, which surface area will be 2 pi r squared, and the other would be the circular, which surface area will be pi r squared. So surface area of a solid hemisphere will be altogether 3 pi r squared. In other words, we can say that surface area of a hollow hemisphere is 2 pi r squared and surface area of a solid hemisphere is 3 pi r squared. But surface area of a sphere, whether it is hollow or solid, it will always be 4 pi r squared. So let's take an exercise on hemisphere. Find the surface area of a solid hemisphere with radius 5 cm. Okay friends, in our next session, we will understand volume of a sphere and also solve some questions.
If you like the video, please hit the like button. Do share it with your friends and post your comments. You can watch the entire syllabus of CBSE Math on our YouTube channel. Do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update. Thank you for watching.